system administrators. They work hard each and every day to configure network devices, provision servers, evaluate performance bottlenecks, and they respond to countless tickets while also making sure each of the systems you rely on are online and operational. It's a hard job, but it's also extremely fun and rewarding. However, it would be nice if we were recognized more often for all that we do. And that's where System Administrator Appreciation Day comes in. It's a day every year where we appreciate our local system administrators. And these are people that work really hard every day, but they're not always thanked for everything that they do, especially when things are running well. So in this video, we're going to talk about System Administrator Appreciation Day. Whether you're a sysadmin yourself or you work with one, there's something in this video for you. So let's get started and talk about how awesome sysadmins are. Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Learn Linux TV. In this video, we're going to talk about System Administrator Appreciation Day and also why sysadmins are just so darn cool. But more importantly, I'm going to give you some advice as far as some ways that you can, you know, appreciate your local system administrator. So I'll give you some advice on that later in the video. But one thing I definitely want to cover is why this particular holiday or annual day of recognition is even necessary in the first place. Before we go any further, though, I need to mention the sponsor for today's video, a sponsor that makes the lives of sysadmins easier. And of course, I'm talking about TuxCare. As a Linux system administrator, imagine being able to drastically reduce your security patching workload while also maintaining system reliability, performance, and uptime. With TuxCare's KernelCare Enterprise live patching solution, sysadmins can put their vulnerability patching on autopilot with automated non-disruptive patches that are applied in the background without anyone on your team needing to babysit a reboot or schedule a maintenance operation. Plus, KernelCare Enterprise covers most popular Linux distributions and can be extended to shared libraries like glibc and OpenSSL, so sysadmins at enterprises large and small can protect their entire Linux estate while shrinking their patching workload, minimizing disruptions, and being able to dedicate more time to other critical tasks. And thank you yet again to TuxCare for sponsoring today's video. TuxCare is awesome. In fact, here at Learn Linux TV, I use KernelCare on all of my production servers and I love it. In fact, be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video because TuxCare has partnered with Admin Magazine to bring you a special download. Now, let's talk about system administrators and System Administrator Appreciation Day. And the first person that I have here to talk about this is somebody that you might be very familiar with because he's the co-host of the Enterprise Linux Security Podcast. So, of course, I'm talking about Joao, and you know what? This day is very special to him, and he's about to tell you why.
So, SysAdmin Day is special to me. I've been a sysadmin for many, many years, and it's very easy to get lost in how important your work actually is. Since you don't get immediate feedback on what you do, it's very easy to lose track of the importance that you have for so many other people's work and day-to-day activities.
And just like Joao mentioned, it's often the case that we may not see the immediate value of our work. Sometimes we as system administrators will implement something on a precautionary basis. For example, perhaps we'll install a patch that's being actively exploited in the wild. Would your company have been hacked if your sysadmin didn't do that? Well, there's no way to know that for sure, but all system administrators know that patching is important, and that's one of the many things that they do to make sure that your workplace, your systems, your servers are in the best possible state that they can be in. But without seeing immediate, you know, results from that, sometimes the results are a lack of action. Maybe it's harder for someone to break into your network because your sysadmin is just that good. And the fact that the hack or breach didn't happen might just be one of the many things that your sysadmin prevented from occurring in the first place. But without seeing any kind of an immediate effect from that, it may not be obvious the impact that that individual is having. But I promise you, without them being present, things would be a lot more challenging. Now, on the other hand, sometimes an issue is very obvious. Maybe something's down, and it could be a service that just about everyone at your work uses and relies on every day. If a service like that goes down, then it's up to the sysadmin to not only fix it, just like normal, but to do so while remaining calm under pressure. And that's something that could be difficult for anybody in any situation in life when you have people asking you, you know, when's it going to be fixed and things like that. And that's a big challenge. And for an example of this, Haneef sent in a video comment about what it's like to be a sysadmin, and he talks about a rather intense situation where he had to remain calm under pressure.
In one of my previous engagements with a company, I was part of a team that handled the on-prem data center. So as a team, we analyzed the IT network and devices in the on-prem data center, and we had realized they had really become obsolete and were on the verge of a failure. So we decided to replace them with new devices before they actually failed and caused production downtime.
And that certainly sounds like an intense situation, doesn't it? You have important equipment that needs to be replaced and is already showing signs of failure. That's a very, very complicated thing to solve. But as Haneef is about to describe, he was able to rely on his team to get through the situation.
So we started the replacement with the help of a local guy who could basically plug into this these devices into the switch on Friday after business hours. The work basically went on for a couple of days, like Saturday and Sunday, as there were a lot of things to configure. We had different environments in the on-prem data center, which needed a lot of isolation and stuff. And then we had to patch them with the latest security updates and stuff. And in between, we also ran into a lot of issues, which needed a lot of troubleshooting, digging in, and sort of things.
However, as intense as that situation was, there was a happy ending.
But fortunately, by Monday morning business hours, we were able to bring the systems up. Even though we really literally had a very tough few days working and getting the systems back up, we were literally happy and satisfied when the users came in and told us the systems were really operating really well.
And just like Haneef mentioned, when you are thanked by somebody, it just feels really good. If you know that you're appreciated and somebody sees value in what you do, or they feel like you saved the day, that just makes you feel really good. And after a situation that's really intense, it's especially important to get some recognition for that situation and the hard work that you put in, which, you know, brings me full circle to System Administrator Appreciation Day, which was created for this very reason. This is a day that's intended to literally raise awareness for the hard work that sysadmins do and the value that they add to your organization. Okay, so how exactly do you go about thanking a system administrator? What is that process like and how do you go about it? Well, I think the only obvious answer here is to buy your sysadmin a Lamborghini. If you can't do that, then maybe you can buy them an all-expenses-paid trip to the Bahamas. I think they'd really appreciate that. But that's also not realistic because that's very expensive. But you don't even have to spend money to thank your sysadmin. And if you do want to spend some money on your sysadmin, you don't have to buy something super expensive. In fact, sometimes it's the little things that matter the most. And that brings me to the first of five tips that I'm going to give you guys for some suggestions when it comes to thanking your local sysadmin. And number one is super obvious. But then again, if this situation was obvious, then Sysadmin Day wouldn't even exist in the first place. But method number one is the cheapest of all because it costs you absolutely nothing. And that is to, well, thank them. Simply thank them. Say, thank you so much for your hard work. That's all.
From a developer who caused far too many SevZero incidents, I'm sorry, but thank you so much for all the things you do. Happy Sysadmin Day.
Hey out there, sysadmins. Rich from Two Guys Tech here. I just want to take a minute and wish you all a happy System Administrators Appreciation Day. You may not know this, but I spent quite a bit of my professional career working as a sysadmin and a network admin, so I understand the joys and the frustrations and the sorrows of working with users and the business, and I just want to say I appreciate the work you do, so keep it up.
Happy Sysadmin Day. Now, I'm not a real system administrator. I just play one at home in my home lab. Now, you might not know who your system administrator is in your organization. They're working around the clock, behind the scenes, to make sure that everything is running the way it should be, that your network is secure, and they're answering all of those emails from those Microsoft error messages. Jokes aside, you should probably find out who it is and tell them thank you. So happy Sysadmin Day, and thank you for taking care of all of the things that people don't even think about.
Another thing that you might consider is throwing a surprise party at work for your sysadmin or your sysadmin team. To get something like this started, maybe you can talk to the manager of that department and let them know that you'd like to do this and find out if there's a company budget for a party like this. Often, organizations do have a spending budget for parties and things like that. So it's a good thing to ask. Maybe this is something you can put together with that person's manager to surprise them, and I think they'd really appreciate that. Now, another way that you could thank your sysadmin is to simply buy them a gift card or simply a greeting card. You don't have to give them a gift card. Sometimes a greeting card is all you need, but the combination of the two is even better, and you don't have to buy an expensive gift card or anything like that. You could simply buy a gift card for a local restaurant. If you happen to know your sysadmin team or your person very well, then you might be able to give them a more personal gift. For example, if you know the answer to the question Star Trek or Star Wars and what that person will respond with, that already gives you something to go on because they'll really appreciate a themed gift for something that they're into. If you have no idea what they're into, I mean, when you pass by their cubicle, you could probably notice some posters or, you know, artifacts on their desk for various fandoms and things that they might be into, which will give you some clues. Just make sure you're not, you know, overly gawking at their desk when they're there because that might be a little awkward. But sometimes just a simple greeting card and or a gift card would be a simple and effective method to let them know that you appreciate their hard work. Moving on, here's another way that you could thank your sysadmin that I think would be fun, but you have to do a little bit of checking first to make sure that you're okay to do this at work. But if you have an all clear from management, I think that this would be a good way to do it. And that is to submit a ticket. No, don't submit a ticket about a printer problem. Trust me, sysadmins hate printers. They all hate printers. It's like the one thing they all have in common. No, don't submit a ticket for fixing something. Submit a ticket to say thank you. And the reason why this is effective is because, well, the ticketing system ends up becoming like this source of anxiety. There's nothing but bad things in there, you know, things broken or things needing to be fixed. So I don't think any sysadmin is excited to check the ticketing queue. They have to, it's their job, but there's usually nothing in there that's positive. But if you submit a ticket that thanks them, I think that'd be something pleasant. Just be sure to, you know, submit that ticket with permission, one, and two, the lowest possible priority. I mean, the last thing we want to do is submit a ticket with a critical tag on it, and then they think it's a big problem and it's not, and then they get sidetracked from something that is a real problem. We don't want to create that situation. So if you create a ticket to thank your sysadmin team, just be sure to submit it with the lowest possible priority. That way, it doesn't get in the way of anything else. I think it'll be fun when a sysadmin opens their ticket queue and they find a thank you message in there, and then they just mark it complete to acknowledge that they read it. I think that'd be fun. And as long as that's not against any company policy, I think that might be a fun way to surprise your sysadmin on this day. Now, for the fifth suggestion that I want to make for you guys, this one is also really easy, but simply give your sysadmin a call on the company phone to thank them, obviously. That's why you're calling them. Because anytime that phone rings, let's be honest, it's just somebody complaining about something being broken, or maybe it's someone trying to sell them something. It's not all that common for a good call to come through the system. So if you are one of those people that call your sysadmin direct when something breaks and you know who you are, then you should especially call them on the phone to thank them. And of course, you could say something like, yeah, there's this big issue. No, I'm joking. You're awesome. And I just wanted to tell you that. I think that'd get a laugh from them if they have that kind of a sense of humor. But if nothing else, just simply tell them that you appreciate the fact that they keep things running and that they're they're an asset to the organization, because without them, well, things wouldn't run all that well or even at all. Now, that's about all I had to say for this particular video. There's not much to say about this. I mean, we need to thank our sysadmins and make sure that they understand how important they are to the organization. Now, if you're a sysadmin yourself, then simply send this video to HR. Maybe they're not even aware that this day of recognition even exists. Again, it's the last Friday in July of every year in your time zone, so maybe send this video to HR to let them know about it. If you're not seeing this video in time, you know, there's always next year. You can let them know about it then. Just set an Outlook reminder or whatever it is you use there at your organization to remind you to send this video to HR. And maybe that might spark some positivity and result in something good happening for the sysadmin. If you can get other people involved, that's even better, because the more people that show, you know, appreciation, the better. And I think that's what it's all about. Before I close out the video, though, the sponsor for today's video, TuxCare, has a special download available for you guys. In fact, TuxCare has partnered with Admin Magazine to bring you this download, and it's called 10 Terrific Tools for the Busy Admin. For a limited time, you can get your hands on this inspiring collection of articles featuring free applications for your admin toolkit. Discover the latest version of 10 terrific tools, which is packed with utilities that will help you do things such as effortlessly manage your .dot files and stay on top of configuration changes, safely communicate with remote hosts using a Bastion server because, you know, security matters. Also, it'll help you uncover hidden processes and keep your system running smoothly with a simple scan. If you're getting tired of bandwidth issues, this download will contain advice for shaping network traffic to ensure seamless office sharing. So definitely grab your copy, and I really appreciate KernelCare's continued sponsorship of Learn Linux TV. Anyway, I just wanted to make this video to raise awareness for SysAdmin Appreciation Day, and I think I've done that. Be sure to send this video to whoever needs to hear this message. I would really appreciate it. You can check out the official website for System Administrator Appreciation Day, which I will have on the screen right now. So you can go there for additional ideas and information about this day. But in the meantime, I thank you for watching this video. Now that you've watched this video, please put it to use and thank your SysAdmin. I would really appreciate that especially. But in the meantime, I'll see you in the next video.